بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو فلا مضل له، ومن يضل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. My dear brothers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is a continuation of the study circle about the Aqeedah Wassitiyyah of Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, and we were discussing the pillars of Iman in the beginning of the book, in which he said رحمه الله والإيمان وقوله والإيمان بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله والبعث بعد اليوم بعد الموت والقدر خيره وشره. So today we'll explain القدر خيره وشره. This concept is very important concept, and many people might misunderstand it. It's important that we try to our best to understand it. It's very simple, it's not very complicated as might people think, but for some reason a lot of people make mistakes in it. But before I continue on the subject matter, there was a question last time about al-bayt al-ma'mur. Al-bayt al-ma'mur is a house Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in the seventh heavens, that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Isra and Mi'raj, he saw it, in which that house, Allah, the angels, 70,000 angels will pray in that house, and they leave and they will never come back. So almost daily you have 70,000 angels will pray in that masjid or bayt or house, and they'll move. So this is give us an example about the number of angels that Allah has created. And the other actually hadith we mentioned last time, that even the heavens is shaking because of the heavy load of the angels. There are so many. We go back to the same subject, which is Iman bil Qada wal Qadar. Al-Iman bil Qada wal Qadar, as I said, it's a very important concept. It's part of our faith, it's part of our Iman. Our Iman is not complete without believing in this. So it's not a matter of saying I would like to have it or not. No, it's very important that we believe in it. And why Sheikh al-Islam mentioned this in his book? Because some groups deviated in understanding al-Qada wal-Qadar a long time ago, even in the days of the Sahaba. And in our time also, we have some people misunderstood and applied this in their lives. So that's why we are talking about the subject, and why the Shaykh actually mentioned it. What does it mean for you, Al-Qada? You know Al-Qada wal-Qadar. You say this word, what does it mean?
Destiny.
And the, I don't know how the dimension of the English language, but the Arabic language is a very strong language, so the meaning usually has more depth in it. So Al-Qada in general, in Arabic language, means the ruling, Al-Qada, when you go to the court, you make Qada or conviction, Okay? So Allah made the Qada. Al-Qadar is whatever has been ruled is going to happen the way it was. Muqaddar is going to happen the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the ruling. So that's what the specific meanings there. We try to simplify the matter as much as we can. So, but what is the evidence in the Quran or the Sunnah? Why we believe in this? If you read the Quran, you have so many verses. فَقَضَاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ وكان امر الله قدرا مقدورا وقضى ربك الا تعبدوا الا اياه. So many words وقضينا في الكتاب يا بني إسرائيل لتعلون في الأرض ولا تفسدن فسادا كبيرا. This is kind of verses in the Quran where Allah سبحانه وتعالى, maybe you need to lower the voice or something. There are so many verses in the Quran talk about qadar. Inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu biqadar. Allah has created things with destiny. So this is the destiny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to believe in. It's not something matter of choice. For Ahl Sunnah and Jama'ah, we believe in the qadar that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hadith, the Prophet said hadith, you know, we have also evidences from the Sunnah. Actually, we mentioned this in the beginning of the first halaqa, that hadith Jibreel, وَأَن تُؤْمِنُ بِالْقَدَرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ. It's part of our iman. Sometimes the qadar is something we don't know, it's coming. Or we something in the past, we might know about it, but something in the coming we don't know. It's unseen, it's unknown. In the Sunnah, the Prophet said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, خَلَقَ مَقَادِيرَ الْعِبَادِ قَبْلَ خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِخَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. Allah had made qadr of his creation, of his slaves, 50,000 years before he created the heavens and the earth. So these things Allah knows about them, has already made his rule about them. So from the book of Allah and the Sunnah, it's obvious that it's not a matter of choice. We have to believe in al-qada wa al-qadr. Now, what qada and qadr means for us and how we apply it in ourselves and what does it mean? This is the important thing. You know, the kuffar, in the Quran, you read also in the Quran, سَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا أَشْرَكْنَا وَلَا آبَاؤُنَا. The kuffar, the mushrikeen, would say, this is a translation from the verse in the Quran. The kuffar or the mushrikeen, they would say, in the day of judgment, if Allah wills, we could not have been kuffar, could have been believers. Allah says after that, قُلْ فَلِلَّهِ الْحُجَّةُ الْبَالِقَةُ. Allah has made it proof on everybody. Allah has sent messengers, revealed his books, sent his words, made it very clear what the message is, that we should believe in him and worship him. And some people will choose not to worship him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, responding to the kuffar or the mushrikeen, they are saying that Allah, if Allah wills, he could have made us believers. No, Allah gave us the choice. Allah gave you the choice to be a good Muslim or a bad Muslim. Allah gave you the choice to be a good believer or a bad believer, or a mu'min or a kafir. This is the bottom line. It's very important to understand this concept, because if you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some people say Allah prescribed this on me to commit this sin. No. You chose to do that sin. You chose to do that sin by your own will. Because we have mashi'ah, we have will, we have irada. We can do things. Allah is not forcing you to come to the lecture. You came by yourself. But Allah knows by His qada and qadar that you will be coming. And may Allah subhanahu reward us all for sitting here. So that in His house. So this is being muqaddar. Huh? See, do you see the difference? It's very important to you understand this. You cannot make excuses. Yani, the kuffar said, if Allah will, He could have gave us the chance not to be disbelievers. Allah gave them the choice to believe, but they chose not to be believers. سَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا أَشْرَكْنَا نَحْنُ وَلَا آبَاؤُنَا. Of course, if Allah wills, He would have done it. But Allah gave you the will. That's what one of the things that we come to in the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we have a will, we have mashi'ah and irada, And Allah has mashi'a and irada. But His mashi'a and irada is not like ours. You see? So whatever is written in the book or the lawh al-mahfuz will happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, the first thing Allah created what? The qalam. I don't know if we can say the pen, but qalam. And He commanded it to write what will be created, happening, and everything till the day of judgment. And it's written in the lawh al-mahfuz, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's all written. So matter what you do, in the end you will do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written in that book for you. Even if you think, okay, I want to do something, and then you change your mind. You're changing your mind, it's already written. That's a very important concept. No matter what you do, you are under the canvas of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are under in the universe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your actions, everything you do, is encountered or circulated by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by His mashi'ah. So we do not run away from it. But inside that circle, we can move around. We can do things. But the things we do in the end will come as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed in the Lawh al-Mahfuz. Okay? So in the hadith Jabir, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the maqadir al-ibad, ma huwa ka'in wa tabarruj, even when wa'alam, he says wa'alam anna ma kana li yusib ma yakhtuk lama lam yakun li yusibuk wa ma asabak lam yakun li yakhtuk, whatever has been happening to you, it will not miss you, and whatever missed you, it will not happen to you. Don't say law, لكن say, don't يعني wish things, but say قدر الله ما شاء فعل. Say what Allah سبحانه وتعالى has prescribed, you will accept His will. So this is a very important concept, and the deviated groups on this understanding, they took two dimensions. One said that Allah does not know what we do. We call them al-Qadariyya. And some group said, Allah is forced us to do this way. We call them al-Jabriyya. Means they are forced. And both actually wrong. Why? In the first case, we explained it. The first case, they say, Allah doesn't know what we will do. But Allah knows. They said Allah would know after we do the action. But if you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He would know after we do the action, what you are saying actually? You are what we call ta'atil. You call it negating. You are calling Allah by things that which does not fit, is not suitable, is wrong. Negates your, invalidate your tawheed. You are saying Allah doesn't know. How come? He's the alim. Allah is the alim. When you say Allah doesn't know, that means Allah, you say that He's not the alim. How many times do you read in the Quran, Allah is alim? So many times. So when somebody say Allah doesn't know what I will do, or He will know after I do the action, he is calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making naqs. He is invalidating and he is degrading Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is invalidate his tawheed, which is wrong. In the same fashion, if somebody says, Allah forced me to do this or that. No. We mentioned an example before that if you study, you will succeed. If you don't study, you will fail. You choose to fail and you choose to succeed. So you have to work to get it. But Allah does not... Who brought you to the masjid? Who brought you to the masjid? You came by yourself, right? We have mashi'ah, we have irada, we have some. We have something we can do. We have the will to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the masjid. But who chose that guy to go for the football match? He chose to go there. He chose not to pray. Allah did not force him not to pray. He commanded them. He revealed books. He sent messengers to guide people to worship him. But they chose, many of them chose not to. That's why we say the Quran says this in many verses. سَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا أَشْرَكُوا. The non-believers will come in the Day of Judgment and say, if Allah wills, He could have not, allowed us not to be mushrikeen. But they choose to be. And Allah says in the Quran, وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنْهُ. Even if Allah bring them back to this dunya, they will do the same thing. They will choose not to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's maybe from me. So again, this concept is very important to concept. So we say these people are wrong and these people are wrong. Now, the al-qada wal-qadar, the ulama say it has four pillars. The first pillar is what we call al-ilm. Al-ilm, Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ فِي كِتَابِ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Allah knows. Allah says, Allah knows. Allah is the alim, what happens in this sky, in the heavens, and in the earth. All of it's written in the book, Al-Mahfum. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ. It's easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is well stated in the Quran. So, it's very important when you say about Qadar that you believe in this your heart that Allah is the Alim, because you cannot get out of it. Allah knows what happened. Allah knows what will happen. And even if it doesn't happen, it were to happen, He would know. So you will not be out of this circle of Allah's knowledge. Allah would know what you will be doing. Even if you say, okay, I want to do this or that, in the end, all of this encompassed in His knowledge, in His ilm. That's why it's very important that al-ilm is a corner, is the pillar of iman in al-qada' wal-qadr. If you remove it, you remove the iman of qadr, because it will negate or invalidate the iman itself. Because when you say Allah doesn't know what I do, it's a problem. That means you're calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He doesn't know. Allah the alim, He knows. We cannot call Allah or describe Him by attributes that negates His tawheed or invalidate your tawheed. If you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you believe He's knowing everything. الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات وسبع سماوات ومن أرض مثلهن يتنزل الأمر بينهن لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما. سبحان الله. This verse, Allah is the one who created the seven heavens and the earths, and He commands between them. He sends His commands and His revelations, or His commands, among these heavens, and Allah is the most known, and His knowledge encompasses everything. That's what the verse means. So, ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is surrounding everything that you might think of. And that means your actions, other people's actions, the actions of the moon, the earth, the sun, all this is all known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Example of that, in the Quran, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels that I will create Adam and his sons. They will be the Khalifa, they will be the ruling of, so they have sovereignty of this earth. And Allah taught Adam, Allah knows that he will Adam and his sons, and there will be prophets, there will be messengers, there will be good and there will be bad people. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَ. Allah knows, Allah taught Adam the names. But he did not teach the angels. He would know and they would not know. The other important pillar or corner of Al-Qadr is Al-Kitaba. And I mentioned this before. Everything is written. You have to believe that everything we do, we say, is written. Written in the book al-Mahfoon that Allah preserved. Our actions, bad or good, are written. Allah knows if we will be shaqiyun am sa'id. In the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, that Allah will create us in our mother's womb for 40 days, then we become nutfa and alaqa and then mudgha, 40 days, that 120 days. After these 20 days, Allah will send the angel and he will write if he will be shaqiyun am sa'id, he will be among the winners or among the losers. And he will write his rizq. Huh? He will write his rizq even. What he will earn this dunya. Am shaqiyun am sa'id. This is from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is an authentic hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. So this, everything is written. And what is written is written. Okay, there is something important to mention here. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have a night called what? Laylatul Qadr. Why we call it Laylatul Qadr? Because in that year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend what will happen in that year, in the first heavens. And that's why we pray that night too much. Huh? And we supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the successful. And to change, because the Prophet said, dua will change the whatever has been prescribed in that year for you. If you supplicate to Allah and Allah accepts your dua and He responds to your dua, it might change whatever was written for you in that day or that night. But even if it's changed, does it change what is written in the back of the book? No. It will come to that. Does Allah know? Yes, of course. He knows that you will come to the masjid and pray and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it will be written. It will come as if it were written before. But Allah gave you the choice, gave you the platform, gave you this dunya to examine you. So, the second pillar we said, writing. Or the book, or kitaba. What we do is written. And the first pillar is ilm. Iman bil qada'a wal qadr has four pillars actually. The other pillar is mashi'a, which means your will. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. We have will, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has will, but His will is different than ours, others. And Allah has given us the will, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can take it. But He chose to give us some, that we use it in this dunya. We choose to be guided, and we choose to be misguided. We might select the right path, some might choose the wrong path. This person will choose to worship Jesus, somebody chose to worship a cow, somebody chose to be a Muslim and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We as humans, we choose. But all of it under the mashi'a of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have changed this will. And He can allow it or disallow it. And the verse we mentioned before, everything is written, inna dhalika ala Allah yaseer, means it's all easy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
the mashia, Allah says, وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates whatever He likes. And He will choose. He chose Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because He found Him the best human being He created. For His traits and for His character, for His truthfulness, His all of the what we know about the Prophet sallallahu Allah says in the Quran, مَنْ يَشَأْ إِلَّهُ يَضِّلْهُ وَمَنْ يَشَأْ يَجْعَلْهُ عَلَىٰ صَرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Allah too, you know, has the will to make you guided and gave you and can make you misguided. So we have to believe in this. This is a pillar of Iman al-Qada' wal-Qadr. Because there is the mashia of a human being, there is a mashia or will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are not the same. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could destroy this universe. Nobody can stop him. But Allah chose to give a human being to live in this world and make all this. So that Allah will select some slaves who worship him and reward him in the hereafter. It's an exam. This dunya is an exam for human beings. Now, the fourth pillar, everything is created. Al-Khalq, creation. Everything Allah has created. Wallahu khalaqakum wa ma ta'malun. Allah has created you and He created what you do. Now, if I hold this water, I am the one who did it. If I hold it, I am the one who did it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what I will be doing. Allah gave me the will to do that. But by the will of Allah, I did it. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you will not be able to do, I will not be able to do. You see what I'm saying? Do you understand these things? Allah khaliq kulli shay'in wa huwa ala kulli shay'in wakeel. Allah is the creator of everything. Now, maybe I give a question. Allah created earthquakes, allowed earthquakes to happen, volcanoes, wars and killing. We see lots of bad things happen around us. Someone will say, why Allah allows this? Because Allah's will, He allowed it. Allah, by His will, He could have prevented it. By His will, we are living in a, mashallah, in a good country. We don't have any, we are living a very peaceful life. Some other brothers in Syria and other places, they are suffering every day. But all of it, by the will of, allowed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's also by His knowledge, He knows. And it's all written also. And Allah knows the creation of the Russians who are bombarding our brothers in Syria. Allah knows. But this is the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya. We have to believe in al-qada' wal-qadar. It's a must in our religion. It's a pillar of iman. Denying it or negating it by any action means you invalidate your deen, invalidate your tawheed. That's why it's very important. Why? This is why Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah mentioned this in his book. And you will find so many verses in the Quran and so many teaching and hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasizing this meaning. اعملوا فكل ميسر لما خلق له. Do your dues. Do your work in this dunya. In the end, you will end up what Allah has prescribed for you. Because Allah knows what we will do. In the end, Allah knows. You will not get out of that circle. Okay? So, I'll go back before I forget that we talked about Laylatul Qadr. It's named Laylatul Qadr because the Qadr or destinies of that year will come down. It's part of that destiny that we are sitting together now. Allah prescribed that and know that we will be doing this. But we did it with our own will. You see the difference? But if somebody tell you that Allah did not know till it's happened, وَعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ is committing يعني, كفر. Or if somebody tells you, no, Allah forced us to come here, this is also not right. Because it negates the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it negates His will, it negates what's written, what His creation. Because what we do actually, part of His own creation. Is that clear, brothers? This is very, يعني many people get astray by this. Sometimes people blame Allah on things that they do. And I've seen this in my life. Some people will tell them, why don't you pray? He says, when Allah give me hidayah, I will pray. You hear this a lot. The hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to strive for it. What made this brother become a Muslim? Or that brother become to the masjid? He, you know, worked for it. He strived to know the right religion of Allah. Then he would know it. Our religion, I said many times, our religion is very simple. People made it very complicated because sometimes of the looks, the women are covered and so forth. No, our religion is very simple. And I said before, do not look at the outside, look at for the inside, because what inside the inside is has the more value. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبُكُمْ. Allah does not look at your looks. Allah look at what you have in your hearts. Allah look at what you have in your hearts. That's why the ibadat like tawakkul, khushu', these things has a great value. Because it's not seen by the people. Allah can know it. When Allah knows what you have in your heart, it has more value. So, I hope this gave you very good understanding of Al-Qadr. If you have any question, inshallah, may Allah help us and answer any comment or question. Jazakumullah khair.